Aaron, release the e-stop. 10 volts. 20. 30. 40. 50. 60.
So we are the Fusar group, Star in a Jar, as a part of the Honors College thesis project. Here specifically, we are building a Hirsch-Farnsworth Fusar. It is an inertial electrostatic containment device. It uses a powerful electrical field to both create and contain a ball of plasma.
So one of the main goals of this project was to be able to make another clean, renewable source of energy with virtually no radioactive waste. The positive side of fusion versus fission is that fusion doesn't create as many radioactive byproducts as fission. Fission, by its own nature, uses heavier elements, which start out radioactive, and after the reaction, they're still radioactive because they're not stable isotopes of their own elements.
70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120. You can see that the purple glow is produced by the plasma inside the inner grid. The glow becomes brighter as more voltage is applied.
Well, when you get down to it though, this is basically just a fancy neon sign. It operates on this pretty much the same principle. We have a high voltage which creates an electrical field in a gas that creates a plasma. Why you see purple here is because the purple wavelength is a part of air's spectral emissions. That being mostly nitrogen with a little bit of oxygen and a few other trace elements. What are we, still getting to what, 400 or 500?
500. This is what our issue is though.
What is?
Do we need a higher stand?
There's gonna be very few instances where you're working on something solely by yourself, and you're gonna be often put in teams with people you may not even know. And I think having the ability to work cohesively in a team and bounce ideas off each other and keep each other in check on task is just such a wonderful trait to have going forward. And I think we really demonstrated that within our group and allowed for further progress to be made simply by having other people.
I think we're very happy with our results. We did accomplish what we set out to do, which was to achieve star mode. We're working towards achieving a more powerful star mode in which we're able to perform nuclear fusion.